So today is Saturday, 2 days after my appointment that I had, and I have been having, excuse the dog, he can sense it, something's going on. So I've been having mild contractions all day, been trying to keep busy because they say exercise helps stimulate labor. So I've been bouncing on my ball, took dog for a nice walk, just been trying to move around and stay active. And then the contractions, they kind of went away. So I'm like, okay, I'll be fine. Just Braxton Hicks probably getting me ready. But I have a really bad headache that does not seem to want to go away. And then I'm giving you the raw and real of it. When I go to the bathroom, I'm still wet. Even after thoroughly wiping it, I'm still wet. So I haven't felt like that gushing or that pop yet. Indicating that my water has broken, but the fact that I can't keep dry underwear is a red flag for me. So I called labor and delivery to see what they wanted me to do. And they said, because I'm 37 weeks and 3 days, that I should at least come in and get checked. I mean, worst case scenario, they send me home. If they test and see that my bag is starting to break, or that I need to stay for other reasons, then they will do so. So this may be the beginning of the labor and delivery vlog. This may just be a false alarm. I don't know, but I will let you guys know.
Jackson might be on the way. I'm here with the mommy to be. She's doing good so far. It might be time. Hey, Dinosaur, I just saw your brothers in the Jurassic Park. There she is. There he is. It might be time, y'all. Let's see what's gonna happen. Jackson's birthday. Look at him. Woo, Jackson. He come. Hey, the wrap up, y'all. He come. He come. He come. Okay, we still in triage, but still. There's my baby mama, all the nice and dark. This looking like, okay, let's get something started. I'm ready to get a jump off. They got some little light thing. You know how they go, bam, bam, bam. The baby on the way. We hope it's a baby on the way. And she said call the prison toilet because, you know, ain't nothing up in here, but it's just her in here, so it's not really a prison toilet. It's private.
It's an open pen.
It ain't right here, but you. And we got curtains here. She said, if you open with that curtain, then bam, Jackson come. And then it's another door here. It's a nice little room, but I'm just going to listen to my little man. He come, pop, pop, pop. He come. It's like a twerking song. He come, pop, pop, pop. He come, pop, pop, pop. He come. And I did tell Josh that he may be born on Father's Day, so I don't know, y'all. Is it ready for it to happen? Is it ready for the come? It's June 19th. Oh, that'd be perfect for him. June 19th. Forever. It's his birthday, Juneteenth. Oh my God. Come on, Jackson. Let's do this.
And as you can see, I am back home. No baby. So it took a while. I guess it was a full moon last night was when it came to babies. Labor and delivery was very busy. I was on the monitor for a while. They said everything was looking good. Then I had to wait a while, to see the doctor. I got an ultrasound to make sure that he's still head down, which he is, thank God. They did the ultrasound to also check the fluid levels just to make sure that he has enough fluid around him. That looks good. Then I had to get a test done, and I guess there's three phases where they test to see if my leaking was amniotic fluid. So it was negative for that. It was no fluid. It wasn't fluid that was leaking. And then they drugged me up really well with regards to the headache. So, no baby. I'm still 2 centimeters. So, of course, they don't admit you until you're like 4 or 5. And you have to have like those really consistent break your back contractions for them to admit you. Especially on a night out. Last night was where they were so busy there. They just don't want to admit you just to take up space. So, I am going to chill today and do absolutely nothing but relax. And if nothing pops off today or tomorrow, I have my appointment on Tuesday with my doctor. She should be back in town. She's out of town this week. So I guess it's like a positive and a negative that it didn't happen last night, because if it did, she wouldn't have been there to deliver him. So Tuesday, she will let me know what she wants me to do.
When I tell y'all, the third trimester tiredness is real, but I got it done. It's Father's Day, so I got it done. Pan-seared pork chops, white cheddar mac and cheese, asparagus, and garlic bread.
My home away from home was here Thursday. Had a scan on Saturday. Here again on Tuesday. Waiting on the doctor. Today I am in the butterfly room. So, waiting to see what's what. It's 6:30 in the morning, and she has dumped out all her blocks and singing nursery rhymes. Blue? Yeah, what color is that? Blue? Blue?
Color,
yeah. Living her best life early in the morning.
Today, there's a better way to help keep decay away. With fortifying fluoride, it can make teeth up to 4 times stronger.
And this is how we load the mix-ins into Blue Bunny's loaded treat. Who
wants to So, it is 7 o'clock. Pretty much have not been consistently asleep since about 1:30 this morning with contractions every 5 to 10 minutes. Leave that bag alone. Yeah, that's your book bag. So we are all just about showered and ready. About to drop the kids off at daycare and then go to the hospital and hope that they keep me. Because if they talk about not keeping me, be careful.
Mama.
I'm finna go roll on the floor.
Mama.
Yes, Neil. What you talking about?
I can't wait till you put, like, Janelle had a full ponytail so she could look like Summer Penguin.
Hey, Jeremy. if today is the day, are you ready to become a father of three?
Sure.
You don't sound enthused.
Sure.
I need more enthusiasm.
Yeah, nah. Been preparing to become a father of three for a long time.
He's so calm.
We've been here before.
Okay. All right, y'all. So we are admitted. It has been one hell of a morning. So we got here. I was having contractions every 5 to 10 minutes, just feeling really icky. I just knew I was going to be dilated to 5 centimeters. Nope, only 3. And they were about to get ready to send me home. They were like, your contractions are not consistent and you're only 3 centimeters. So we're going to go, you know, we're going to send you home to labor some more. And I, like, literally, I had tears in my eyes because I'm like, we done drove all the way here. I feel like crap. So the Lord must have heard me. So the nurse practitioner was like, oh, well, let me give you an ultrasound before you go. Just to make sure that everything is good. So she starts the ultrasound. Jackson is still head down. And then she's like, oh, well, your pockets of fluid are really low. So let me, she was like, let me have the doctor come in and make sure that my measurements are correct. So the doctor comes in like, yep, your pockets are low. So, you know, you're past 38 weeks. So even the littlest thing, you know, once you're full term, we go ahead and get the baby out. So we're going to induce you. So I'm here. Now, let me tell you how small the world is. The nurse practitioner, I guess she looked at my old charts and stuff like that. And she was like, oh, do you remember me? She was like, I was the one that admitted you with your last delivery. And I'm like, I'm sorry, I don't remember you. But she was like, yeah, I see my name in your chart and this, that, and the other. And then a resident had came in because he came behind her just to confirm my dilation of being 3. And he had a very distinctive voice. Plus, there's not too many, they say it's not too many males for the OBGYN unit. So the same resident that came and checked me today was the same resident that delivered Janelle. So I'm like, this is a small world. So then got all my paperwork and all of that stuff. Came over to my labor and delivery room. We are in the same room that I delivered Janelle in. So we are 3 for 3. My doctor is here. So hopefully we have a baby before she goes home, because ain't no more chances for her to deliver a baby. She didn't get a chance to deliver Deuce or Janelle. So I'm hoping she gets to deliver this one. It's personal. So I will keep you all in the loop as much as I can. I'll give y'all a room tour. So when you first come in, you got the door. That second door is the bathroom. Monitors and all that fun stuff. I think there's a sink and some other stuff over there by that curtain. Got a bouncing yoga ball. That's where Jackson's gonna be. TV, peanut ball. I think that's where they keep all of the epidural stuff at. Jeremy's bed. There was a cart in here. I mean, not a cart, a couch. But they said the couch broke. So now they just have the bed in here. There's a chair. And then they got a TV tray. Lights for delivery. Counter space over there with more tools and stuff ready to go for baby. So very, very spacious. And like I said, this is the same room I had Janelle in. Very, very special.
Now, I get it. You're supposed to be on a clear diet when you're in labor. But they done sent vegetable broth up here and chicken broth. This stuff tastes like hot water. Only thing that's kicking is this apple juice. Tragic. Knock out. I thought I was the one in labor.
Okay.
Everybody said he getting his rest for later.
I didn't get a chance to press the record.
I gotta do it now.
Not missing the third one.
He came out hollering.
I feel so much better.
I know you do. Yeah, though. Oh, he's so mad. You ready to eat mine? Is you ready to eat?
I'm sorry.
Say, yeah, I'm going to eat my fingers. See, I'm going to eat my fingers.
All
right.
Thanks,
Doc. He's so mad. He said, I came out, I'm hungry. I'm ready to eat. Y'all messing with me. Look at him trying to turn over already. Ooh, he's so mad. You say they ain't even have to check your lungs. You came out hollering. He's like, he mad.
He's really trying to come out, you know?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
He knew what he was doing.
I did my best to hold him in.
He did a great job.
Did you like the feeling of
can see how big you are.
Okay, I have a little bit of water and I'm just gonna kind of let it run past, okay?
It'll be so good.
Hey, little man.
Yeah, I told you he ready to eat. He was trying to eat people's fingers up. He ready to eat.
Okay.
Look at that face.
Oh, you are too cute.
Mm-hmm. Looking like his brother.
Placing his security bands. We didn't go anywhere that we don't know about.
Yeah, that's that nurse side.
Oh my God, it's terrible how he looks like this.
Mm-hmm.
You know that the nurse side when you were kicking to action.
Watch on.
You kick into action.
Well, I did it, y'all. That was the by far out of all three. That was the worst labor ever. I will go into more details when I get some sleep. But right now we are just a little over 2 hours postpartum. Baby has had all his vitals taken. He has eaten twice. Greedy boy already. And I got all nice and cleaned up. So we are waiting on patient transport to come and get us so that we can go over to the postpartum unit.
Hey,